Okay, sorry about that, Tim.
It's okay.
You were saying that when you look out at this, you see the bank and then you see what's next to it?
Yeah, it's a great example of good decisions versus bad decisions. Sometimes bad decisions, which you can't reverse, or it's very difficult to reverse because the historic structure has been damaged or covered over. On the right side, this is a good example of what communities are trying to do all over the nation by having very viable small businesses that are great for the community and great for visitors. We have Origin Coffee, which puts out great food and amazing coffee. It's set out on the street, cafe style. And on the right, John Diamond's bicycle shop. It's perfect. And these are relatively two new businesses when you compare it to the third shop on the right, which is Don Finnegan, an amazing historic building that he's preserved, as well as the interior of the store all these years. So you have bad decisions, new really good decisions, and then Tom making the best decision we can make with a historic building and keeping it viable all these years. So, you know, that kind of shows the new and the old with a very bad decision for the bank, which was done, I think, back in 1962. So it reminds you that you constantly have to be vigilant about decisions you make and how they affect people years from now. It has long-term effects. So we're fortunate. We do have quite a few historic buildings, and people realize now that they have to be preserved. And it's so important for the economy on Saranac Lake to preserve these buildings.